Episode 1348, It Hurts Too Much.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. It is Wednesday. Yes, you are halfway through your week. Woohoo! Put on your smiling face because that should give you some energy today. Well, it's Wellness Wednesday, and you know what? It hurts too much. Let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You're going to want to be on the inside scoop, so be sure that you're listening here on the podcast and that you've signed up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter. That's where you will know, you'll be the first to know the inside scoop. You want to be part of the Founders Club, right? All right. Deep breath, because it's all about health, it's all about wellness, and it's all about pain. Once you start working out, next comes one of the biggest setbacks. Oh, the pain. It hurts too much. No one's got time for pain. This is the biggest thing ever. Oh man, Christiane, you gave me this workout. It's great, but I am so sore. And it lasts for more than 12 hours, 24 hours, 3 days, 4 days. And you're like, I can't do this anymore. I still have to live my life. But when you are wanting to transform your body, you will experience pain, some good and others that make the daily walking a bit challenging. You understand pain. You know that it's going to happen, but one rest day leads to more than what you had planned. And that means what? Then you're back into your old rhythm again. You think, oh, if I just take off a day, another day, another day. Transformation no more. Your goals put on the back burner once again. What if you could work out and soothe your muscles with a little extra love and care? Don't give up on you just because your muscles are being built. Remember, when we are building our muscles, we are tearing them down. And it really kind of seems graphic if you think about it. When you're working out, you're doing your strength training, resistance training. I'm not just talking about cardio. Okay, cardio is for another episode. This is actually building your muscles. Not that you can't have muscle soreness from cardio, but that is in relations to other things. This is for mainly strength training. When you're really trying to work like your biceps, your triceps, your quads, your glutes, your hamstrings, your calves, you're like, oh my gosh, I'm just to sit down. It hurts. I know I've been changing my workout recently and boy, am I feeling it. And it's a good feeling, but it's also one that can be a setback. And when you're trying to come back from something, the last thing that you want to do is to have a setback, and pain can be just that. You want to run away from it. But understand that your muscles are being built. In order for your muscles to be built, they have to be torn down. So they're broken down, which means, yes, you need those rest days in between. So if you're doing a total body workout and you're thinking, okay, I'm doing all of this muscle for my entire total body, then you need to total body rest yourself the next day. When it comes to strength training, can you do a little cardio? Yes. Could you ride your bicycle? Yes. But don't involve extra weight. Okay. That's just kind of your foundational rule. Also, I don't want you to think that, okay, I'm hurting now. So then come the next day when I'm supposed to be doing my strength training, I may feel pain, but is there a good pain? Is there a bad pain? Pain is just a big, huge question mark in our mind because our bodies want to protect us. Our mind, our brain is so intuitive. It says, whoa, pain, maybe you shouldn't be doing that. And then what happens? Oh, the floodgates of excuses open up. Don't give up on you just because your muscles are being built. It's time to take the leap. Transform your body one step at a time, right? Work with the pain. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Work with the pain. With a vigorous workout challenge, your muscles are going to be sore. If you've never been told that, well, mark today down, you're going to hurt. There's going to be pain, but it's awesome. And you're going to feel good because you see, once when you do that workout, you know what I'm talking about, right? You know what I'm going to say here? The endorphin rush. Woo, it's a high. And when you get that, you're like, oh, I'm on fire. But then the pain begins to set in, that soreness, that tightness, that I can't believe I just did that to my body reaction. And some of us, if we haven't been doing it in a while, we're like, okay, I'm going to step back. And it becomes a setback instead of a step forward. You're not going to step back any longer because giving up is not an option. You're going to work with the pain. So let's break it down. I want to give you some opportunities here to really begin to work with that pain. Now, understand this. If you're having pain that's consistent and there's no release of it over a couple days, a week time, and it's something that continually is there or progressively gets worse, that's a big red flag. You need to stop what you're doing and go visit with your medical provider or your physician because you may have done something more than, oh, I'm just sore from breaking down my muscle. There could be something otherwise happening within your body. You know your body best, so stay in tune with your body. No one else. I don't care if your personal trainer is standing right next to you in the same room. They cannot feel what you're feeling. Only you can. So it's important to really begin to listen to that body. So if it's pain that's like, oh, I'm just kind of uncomfortable. It hurts like just to kind of sit down. Like, you know, when you're working those glutes after doing lunges, oh my goodness. I have a love-hate relationship with burpees and lunges. They do great things, but I don't like the feeling that I get always from them afterwards. And so my glutes, if I'm really working it and if I've increased my weights, et cetera, oh, they can be on fire. And I can be sitting down and I go to stand up and I'm like, oh my gosh, I think I'm picking up a boulder. I mean, literally my legs feel like that. They're so heavy. But over time, they get better. Okay, so that's normal. That's a normal reaction. But if you're getting up and it's like you're limping, there's a problem there. So understand the pain, where it's coming from, and that will help you know whether or not to, okay, I've got to go take action with my medical provider, or no, it's just really I'm breaking down my muscles so I can build more up. All right, so let's get into it. When it comes to working with the pain, what do you do? Number one, you know what I'm going to say. Yes, you do. Hydrate, pre, post, and during. Drink water. Okay, I didn't say any other kind of clear liquids, water. Now, if you are really sweating it out big time, some of our advanced fitness people, gurus out there, if you're one who's just honing in on it and you're doing 35, 50 pound weights, and you're just like, oh my gosh, you may have to replenish with some electrolytes and sodium. So you'll need that type of a drink. So yes, you can think of it as a sports drink. I would make sure and encourage you to read the labels when you're doing that because not every sports drink is created the same. So ultimately though, if you are wanting to do what's best for your body, God made it. There's a lot of it, and it's called H2O, water. Hydrate. You cannot drink enough. So be sure to do it pre, post, and during your workout. That's where you have to start. Because when your muscles, when your cells are dehydrated, you already put them in a stress factor. And they're freaking out already. And so your body is pulling in other things, and it can't release. So sometimes when we're dehydrated, we're not even sweating like we need to sweat. So it's important to hydrate. Number two, eat properly with good protein. If you're tearing down muscle, that means you've got to build muscle. And in order to build muscle, you must eat protein. It's just a fact. You can't tear down your muscle and not have anything. So be sure that you are eating plenty of protein to build up those muscles, especially after a post-workout. Now, we'll do some things regarding pre-workout and post-workout eating that we can spend hours on in that area alone. So right now, though, I just want to highlight to make sure that you are eating protein when it comes to your strength training. You've got to be eating protein. Okay, number three, warm up prior to your strength training. In fact, your warm up needs to be considered part of your workout. I have a lot of people who say, oh yeah, I do this workout, it's 20 minutes. But it's only the strength part of it. They don't take into account the warm up and the cool down portion. All of our stretching, our warm-ups, our cool-down, that should all be part of your workout time frame. So if you're like, I only have 20 minutes, and you're trying to do a 20-minute routine, so to speak, a 20-minute workout, and you're not tacking on the warm-up and the cool-down or stretching, whatever you want to call it in your brain, then you need to adjust your main workout because your body needs to warm up prior to your strength training. Hitting it cold is not good. And you want to do dynamic warm-ups, dynamic stretching, okay? That's very, very important. You can do jumping jacks. You can do moguls. You can do chest like star jacks. There's lots of different ways you can warm up. Number four, I already mentioned it before, but stretch it out before and after your workout. This too must be a part of your workout time. Don't leave this as just, oh, well, yeah, I guess I should do it. No, you need to do it. And you can do it throughout the day. So your stretching doesn't have to be just during your workout period. You can do stretching throughout the day. So if you're going to bed at night and you worked out in the morning and you're like, oh, man, my glutes are still kind of feeling. Well, do some stretches. Stretch out those hamstrings, those quads, those glutes before you go to bed. That really does help. Again, your whole workout time frame, when you're looking at saying, I'm scheduling this, I'm scheduling me on the calendar, this is my lifestyle time, and it's going to be for 20 minutes, that needs to include everything, okay? Number five, after a hard workout, and that means like you're dying here. Literally, you just feel like, oh my gosh, I've lifted so much, my muscles are dead tired. I've done that a few times. And oh, I got to tell you, a hot shower is nothing that I want to climb into. Enjoy an ice bath or a really, really cold shower. So don't even turn on any warm water. Just literally stand there in front of the faucet and turn it on to cold and just let it hit you. Now, I know this sounds crazy, but your professional athletes out there will tell you they ice bath all the time. There's some really good research that goes into taking ice baths. Now, most of us don't have enough ice in the house to take an ice bath. So that's why I recommend a really cold shower. No warm water, just turn it on. Immediately stand there, be ready for it, and just let it hit you. You're going to wake up and you're going to be like, woo! So you thought the endorphins were really good with that rush. Well, this cold water is going to rush you even more. So experiment with that. It may or may not be for you, but it is an option. Number six, use heat as you progress throughout your day. And what I mean by that is if you're going to ice yourself, then you can heat yourself later. And that's going to relieve tension and tightness within the muscle. You can also ice down your muscles. So if you've got one area that you're like, oh man, I just can't get that, and a cold shower isn't working, then you can ice that particular area in place of immersing yourself in a full body ice bath, okay? Same with heat. You don't have to heat your whole body. Sometimes it's a good excuse to have a second or third shower for the day if you want to take a really, really hot bath or shower. But you can just take a heating pad or a thermal heating pack and just place that on the area that's really, really tight. All right. Number seven. Okay. You don't even probably, you can't even imagine this one. Pineapple. Yes, I'm from Hawaii. I love me a good pineapple. Oh, they're so yummy, especially fresh out of the garden. Oh, there's nothing better. My mouth is already salivating, but pineapple is awesome. And it really does the muscles good. You can also use tart cherries. And the reason for this is bromelain is an enzyme and it's an anti-inflammatory. It has natural benefits like an anti-inflammatory would. So having some pineapple in your shake right after you're done working out is great because it works like an anti-inflammatory does. And it's what? Natural. So try some pineapple in a shake or just eat some fresh. Fresh is always better in my opinion. So watch for them. And when you pick your pineapples, if you're wondering how to pick a good pineapple, have you wondered? Okay, so when you look at your pineapples, you know they have the little shapes of them. I call them kind of like the triangle shape. It depends on how they've grown. The more even they are from top to bottom, the better the pineapple overall because it's evenly done. Some are really, you know, smaller on top and they get bigger on bottom, not so much. So go for the more evenness on the pineapple. Okay, that was just bonus. Number 8, use your sore muscles the day after. None of us like this one. Rest is good, but keep moving. So let's say you do leg day. Okay, you're doing your lower strength training. And you're like, oh, I cannot take any more on these glutes. My quads are on fire. I walk or I try to stand up after, you know, I go down from a squat to get something out of a kitchen cabinet and I stand up and I'm like, ah, you're yelling and screaming. I know, been there, done that, doing it too. However, you've got to still move. You can't just be kind of this robot that doesn't do anything that next day. So you intentional movement is key. So yes, the next day, maybe you're going to do steady state cardio. And that's just maybe you go for a walk and it can be a brisk walk, but it doesn't have to be like a full out jog or run, but it's cardio. So you're moving, you're grooving, you've got your lower extremities working, but you're not holding yourself back by not doing anything. Okay. What you want to rest from is actually using strength training on the areas that you trained for the day before. Finally, oh, not finally, we've got 2 more. Number 9, sorry about that. Foam rolling and massage. So good. Now, if you can get your hubby to jump on board with the massage, I'm all in. Okay, not me all in, you should be all in. Say yes, take him up on it if he's willing to do any form of massage. Maybe you go to a massage therapist on a regular basis. Great, schedule it when you're really gonna do your harder days, that following day or two or three afterwards so you can gain that benefit. And also foam rolling. We've talked about foam rolling before. It's really good. We'll probably do some training on that here coming up. Yes, you'll probably be wanting to pay attention to the AIM Academy. But foam rolling is something that will help relieve that tightness and the tension within your muscles. And you can really pinpoint exactly where you want to focus on. So it is great. I use it almost daily. So one of my favorites. It's not always the easiest thing to do because it can be a little uncomfortable, but it's something that I do encourage. Number 10, finally, topical treatments. People are like, oh, can I put stuff on my skin? Yes. However, be sure to read the label. Know what you're putting on your body. Know what's in the stuff that you're putting on your body. One thing I would recommend in regards to a topical treatment would be an Epsom salt bath. Those are incredible. So if you can take time out to take a nice warm bath, and if you're to the point where, hey, you know, heat does my body good, then great. Do a hot bath with Epsom salt baths and just relax. 10, 15, 20 minutes if you can. Some of your alone time. Huh. Instead of getting the massage from the hubby, let him take the kids and you get your time off in the bath and just enjoy it because your muscles do. There's just something magical about the Epsom salts, how it works, how it gets in to your body, what it does, and it does release that tension. Now, this is a lot thrown at you, but the thing is here that I want you to think about, you are made for more. And you know this. You've known this because you come back every single day for more. You know that you're created on purpose for a greater purpose. you know that God has dreams far beyond anything you can imagine. You do not want your health to get in the way of living out God's heavenly plans for you here on earth. So don't dive into the excuses. Don't settle into, I'm just going to rest an extra 2, 3, 4, 5 days. However, understand that I've said it before, listen to your body. If you're exhausted and you just cannot drag yourself out of bed to work out the next day, that is something that you need to listen to. If you're totally exhausted and you're falling asleep cooking dinner, there's a problem there. Maybe you are pushing yourself a little too much. Sometimes, believe it or not, we can be a little gung-ho. So ultimately, listen to your body. But also more importantly, don't give in to the excuses that you've given into before. It's easy. It's tempting every single day. I know. I live it. I get up in the morning. I'm like, yeah, don't want to work out today. What excuse can I come up with this time? And I think, oh man, I could do this. Nope. And I'm thinking, okay, if I make the bed, I won't get back into the bed. And so then I will go work out. Or if I put on my workout outfit and I didn't wash it, I'm not going to sit down anywhere because, well, I don't want it to be smelly on everything else that I have. So it forces me to work out. We come up with every excuse we can. It's time to drop the excuses. No more excuses. Don't let the pain get in the way of your transformation. Not at all. If you're wanting some help with figuring out what you want to be doing, how you need to be working with your body, maybe you have some areas that you're like, I just don't even know where to begin. I've had so many children. Whatever your story is, you have the opportunity to have a coaching call with me. Click on the link, take AIM in the show notes. It's my complimentary gift to you. All you do is fill out that little form there. It's very short. It comes directly to me. No other eyes see it. I promise you that. And when I get that, then I will send you back an email that says, let's schedule you. And we will get you scheduled for a coaching call. We're going to talk story. I love talking story. So with all of that, it's time to push the pain to the sidelines. No longer is an excuse for you. It's time to create your now. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.